Now, all being well, you're going on to the final stitching, which is the side stitching, which is going to bring the whole of the abaya together. It's like a curvature type of coat, like a buckling sleeve this is. Now, you're going all the way around and actually approaching where the pockets are inserted. And my suggestion or my advice would be to stitch down about an inch below the area of the pocket, double stitch it, and then break off your thread. Then work down, making sure that your fabric is absolutely parallel and there's no, if you pull it from here, it should actually sit evenly. And what you are doing is leaving approximately 6 inches and 6 inches and about a centimeter in from the pocket seam, you're going to be seaming down to the hemline. And you need to start this and then back tack and go all the way down. And then we will come back and finish the curvature of the roundness of the pocket once we've finished stitching. Don't be tempted to go around the pocket and finish on the one go, because that will actually create you problems. Now, realistically speaking, you are talking about an hour to 2 hours of time making this abaya. It's not a hard sewing thing. The only thing that takes time is the preparation. And you know what? The whole point, the whole neatness and the whole beauty of this abaya actually comes from how careful you are on your preparation stitches. And I'll go back to that and I'll just show you something that... Now you go back to the pocket and start off from within the seam, just seam down a little and then seam down a little more, and then you just want to go around making sure that there's no, I mean, you can pin it and you can work slightly slower than what I'm doing. This is all down to, obviously, down to experience and down to I'm sorry, I do tend to rush at times. And what we're going to do is come in, join the seams and break off just a little bit below the point of the seams. And this is so that all around there's no holes or anything, and it just reinforces. So when you insert your hand, this is sort of the depth of the pocket below the actual seaming line. Now going on to the other side, I've still not overlocked this. I'll go back to the overlocker all at once and hopefully finish this off. Now we're going to go back to the other side. And again, similar technique, we're going to be working towards the inside of the shoulder area, inside the armpit area. And it's like a round... don't seam too far deep in, because it's a round curvature and it actually will not sit properly if you take a very, very deep stitching. You can work on a margin of about a centimeter, an inch is too much, because the seaming does not actually sit. Now, even if you have a slight bit of unevenness in your pockets, it really doesn't matter, because we're going to later on be trimming into this with the overlocker, with the serger. Break away your thread, go down, and again straighten the whole of your fabric out, making sure that there's no unevenness in this, and also trying to make sure that your distance of these pockets is sort of like parallel. You don't want to have too much of the one and too less of the other. Back to the pocket and start off slightly higher, work down, turn the fabric around and keep your fabric parallel and work around the outer skirt, outer line of the pocket area, sort of keeping it absolutely even. So that going to go back and overlock the whole of the outer circles, and then we've just got to trim it to size at the bottom, making sure that all the sides are absolutely even. Hem the bottom. I'll come back and show you how I'm going to hem the bottom. Also try out for size before attaching the cuffs in front of the sleeves. Now earlier on I was mentioning the neatness factor and what determines the overall effect is actually good bits of pressing. Now, a good bit of pressing is often a result that you can get like this. These are the cuffs that I've prepared. Now, you can tell the neatness of this by the fact that this has been all neatly, very very neatly pressed. So the cuffs, pre-prepare all your bits and bats, and you know what, I have oh god, I can't believe what I've just gone and done. Okay, we're all susceptible to mistakes, and what I've done is I have gone and done the pattern on one side and on the other. Oh god, I can't believe I did this. Okay, I will have to open one of the cuffs and redo the outer side seaming, because I've gone and attached this. The flowers will be facing the opposite way. So there you are, there's a blunder. I simply cannot believe I've just gone and done this, honestly. Okay, there we are. Now, okay, what we need to do is, now that I've opened this up, I need to take it back to the ironing board and I need to press this back into shape first. Okay, now I'm going to pause here and I'm going to show you my little steam gadget, iron gadget as well.